And why do we have to concentrate in wudu? Sheikh Shahabuddin Sohrawardi rahimahullah says that the one who attains concentration in wudu will automatically attain concentration in salah. You know, a lot of us, we perform wudu, we only perform wudu because we think this is not necessary. We don't have to do anything in wudu. We just wash our face, wash our hands, do masa, wash our feet. And then the maqsad, the motive is salah. There's no doubt in that. But wudu itself is an act of worship. It's a key for the prayer. It is also an act of worship. And when you enjoy wudu, you will enjoy your prayer. So that's another important thing. And wudu is wuzu. Wuzu and wudu is the same. Wudu is in Arabic. Someone said, brothers were asking me that, someone asked the question, is it Ramadan or is it Ramazan? All our life we've heard Ramazan and now it's Ramadan. So it's the difference of pronunciation. The real word in Urdu is Ramazan and the word in Arabic is Ramadan. So dot pronounced in Arabic. In wudu, how do you take concentration? Remember, again, when you make wudu, think that this is the last wudu of my life. And there are many more things. I'm just giving you some principles. There are so many other principles, the points that you have to work on, inshallah. And you get used to it. You don't have to spend more time to act upon these principles. You don't need additional time to act upon these principles. If it takes you 5 minutes to make wudu, it will still take you 5 minutes to make wudu. It's just your mind is thinking about it. When you make your wudu, when you wash your hands, think about the sins of the hands leaving the body. Remember, when you wash your hands, the sins of your hands are washed away. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, he used to see the sins of people and then he make dua. He would see the sins of people leaving from the hands and from the eyes, from the ears, from the feet. As they are washed away, then he made dua. Allah, take this karama away from me. I do not want to know the sins of people. So when you wash your face, then your eyes, the sins of your eyes leave from the body. When you wash your face, you will make tawbah. You will say, oh Allah, I will not commit these sins with my eyes. And also, you imagine the nur of your face increasing. Because that is what happens. People will be, the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment will be recognized by the nur of the parts of the body which were washed in wudu. Shiny. So he'll say, Ya Allah, this is my last opportunity to increase the nur of my face, increase the nur of my hands, my arms, increase the nur of my feet. This is my last. So enjoy the coolness of the water. Enjoy the water. I may never be blessed with this opportunity of purifying myself, of increasing the nur, of the sins leaving my body. That's how you enjoy the wudu. And other than that, there are some other du'as that I gave recently. These du'as are important. If you can't memorize these du'as, the message and the mafhoom that is given in these du'as, understand that and think about that when you perform in wudu. When you wash, when you rinse your mouth, you read this du'a. Bismillahi, Allahumma a'inni ala tilawati al-Qur'an wa zikrik wa shukrik wa husni ibadatik. So you make this du'a. When you rinse your mouth, if you can't memorize this du'a, make time, take the du'as from the brothers, after the lectures are aired on Airway QTV, take the notes in detail and then memorize these du'as and inshallah ta'ala, if you memorize them with translation, memorize them with translation and think about the message that is being conveyed in these du'as. Bismillahi, Allahumma a'inni ala tilawati al-Qur'an wa zikrik wa shukrik wa husni ibadatik. Bismillahi, with the name of Allah. Then you say, Allahumma, oh Allah, a'inni ala tilawati al-Qur'an. Oh Allah, help me in reciting al-Qur'an. Oh Allah, help me in reciting Al-Quran al-Karim. Wa zikrik, and help me in your zikr, in your remembrance. Wa shukrik, and help me in thanking you. Wa husni ibadati, and the best of your worship. Meaning you're rinsing your mouth and you're asking Allah, oh Allah, help me in using my tongue in the recitation of Al-Quran al-Karim. Wa zikrik, meaning it's all about the tongue. You use your tongue for reciting the Quran. You use your tongue to make zikr of Allah. You use your tongue to do ibadah of Allah Jalla wa Ala. So you say, oh Allah, help me in all of these ibadah. And the second is, when you clean your nose, Bismillahi, Allahumma arihni raihat al-jannah, wa la turihni raihat al-nar. Oh Allah, make me smell the sweet fragrance of Jannah. Oh Allah, make me smell the sweet fragrance of Jannah. So when you clean your nose, you think about the fragrance of Jannah. And then you say, oh Allah, do not make me smell the stench of Jahannam, the bad smell of Jahannam. And then when you wash your face, Allahumma bayyid wajhi yawma tabyaddu wujuhun wa taswaddu wujuhun. Oh Allah, brighten my face. Oh Allah, make my face shine on the day when many faces will be white and many will be black. Many will turn white and many will turn black. That is the dua that you make. So you imagine the nur of your face increasing because of wudu. And you imagine how your face will shine on the day of judgment when many faces will become black on the day of judgment. And then you say, when you wash your right arm, Bismillah, Allahumma a'tini kitabi bi yamini wa hasibni hisaban yaseera. Oh Allah, give me my book in my right hand. So you imagine on the day of judgment, when you wash your right arm, you imagine on the day of judgment when the book will be given. Ya Allah, if only the angel comes and gives me the book in my right hand. So that is when you wash your right arm. And when you wash your left arm, Bismillah, Allahumma la tu'tini kitabi bishimali wala min wara'i sahri. Remember the sinful people, the evil people, the kuffar, they will be given the book either in the left hand or the angel will come from behind the back and he will give them the book. اللهم لا تؤتني بكتابي بشمالي ولا من وراء ظهري. Oh Allah, do not give me my book in my left hand and do not give me my book from behind my back. And then when you make masr of your head, بسم الله اللهم أظلني تحت ظل عرشك يوم لا ظل إلا ظل عرشك. Oh Allah, place me under the shade of your throne on the day of judgment, on the day when there will be no shade other than your shade, other than the shade of your throat. So this is, you make this dua when you do mas over your throat. This mas, the blessing of this, is on the day of judgment, I will be under the zil, under the shade of the throne of Allah Jalla wa'ala. And you make dua of that. And then when you do mas of your ears, then you say, Bismillah, Allahumma ja'alni min allazina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana. Bismillah, Allahumma ja'alni min allazina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana. In the name of Allah Jalla wa Ala, oh Allah, make me from those who listen with concentration, who concentrate while listening. Sami'a yasma means to listen. Istama'a yasma means to concentrate. فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَا. Oh Allah, make me from those who act upon it in the best manner. In the best manner. Not just the listener, not just the one who concentrates. Who concentrates and acts upon it. That is when you do masa of your ears. So you have to make the intention of that also. That I will listen to every message of Islam, I will concentrate, and I will be the best one from those who act upon it. And then when you do masa of your neck, Bismillah, Allahumma a'tik raqabati minan nar. Oh Allah, free my neck from the fire. You make this dua. And then when you wash your right foot, you make this dua. Bismillah. Allahumma thabbit qadami ala sirat yawma tazillu al-aqdam. You imagine the pool sirat when you're washing your feet. So you think about the pool sirat and you say, oh Allah, bless my feet with steadfastness, bless my foot with steadfastness on the sirat yawma tazillu al-aqdam, on the day when many feet will slip, when many people will fall. And when you wash your left foot, Bismillah, Allahumma ja'al zambi maghfuran wa sa'yi mashkuran wa tijarati lan tabura. Oh Allah, make all my sins forgiven. When you wash your left foot, you say, oh Allah, make all my sins forgiven and make all my efforts accepted. Accept all my efforts and all my trade and my business such that in which there is no loss. Meaning, oh Allah, bless me with success. This is what you think about in wudu. And with the blessings of this, you will gain concentration in salah. And also, the most important thing in the month of Ramadan, and also to ask upon after the month of Ramadan, is to remain in the state of wudu.